There's been a little bit of confusion about the different types of graphs that arise when solving these differential equations. So I thought it might be good to go over the solution to quiz one in a bit more detail to highlight this. So we're solving differential equations of this sort, dx dt equals f of x, and I've given you the graph of f of x. And we can come up with a phase line for this. We can also sketch solutions, x as a function of t. And to make this discussion a little bit more concrete, I think it will help to reinterpret this as a population growth problem. So let me do that. So all I'll do is replace the variable x by the variable p, and we'll think of p as the population size. And since we're measuring population in these funny units, maybe this is population in metric tons of biomass or something. So it's not like there's one, if we're talking about rabbits, I don't think there's one rabbit, two rabbits, three rabbits. So we won't worry too much about the units here. But the idea is that we have a population that's changing in time, and this says the growth rate, if it's growing or shrinking, how fast, is a function of the current population. So then this graph, the axis here is population p, and then this is the growth rate, how the population is changing. So we can see if the population is between 1 and 9, then the population will increase because the growth rate is positive. The population is growing. If the population is greater than 9, then the population will decrease because the growth rate is negative. And if the population is less than 1, the growth rate will decrease, again, because the population is negative. So from this information, I can sketch possible solution curves for this differential equation. So let me do that. Okay. So here are my axes. This is now time on the horizontal axis and population on the vertical axis. I've sketched the fixed points, the two stable points, 1 and 9, just as dotted lines. These are fixed points because the growth rate is 0. When the growth rate is 0, the population p doesn't change. If I start, say, at 2, I'll increase until I get to 9. So I could sketch that here. I'm increasing, and I'm approaching 9. If I started at 5, I would also increase and approach 9. It's going to look something like this. If I start at 12, I'll decrease and hit 9, approach 9. And if I started a little less than 1, I would decrease and go 0. Okay, so these purple curves, I would say these are solutions to this differential equation for four different initial conditions. So these purple curves are p as a function of t. So let me just say a little bit again about these two types of graphs, because it's really easy to get them confused. So this is dp dt as a function of p. Is the population growing or shrinking for a given population? So there's no time on this axis. This plot is p as a function of time. How does the population vary as time goes forward? Right, so we can see that solutions approach the stable fixed point at 9 and are pushed away from the unstable fixed point at 1. So lastly, another type of graph that we can draw is the phase line for this. And if you do that, again, we can see that there's a stable fixed point at 9 and an unstable fixed point at 1. And in fact, you could draw the phase line right here on this axis if you wanted. I'll do that in a different color so it stands out. Let me grab a bright red pen. So in this region, between 1 and 9, the population is growing. It's moving to the right. Why? Because this graph is positive, and when this graph is positive, that means the growth rate is positive. So the arrows here have to go like this. If I'm over here, the population will get smaller because the growth rate is negative. The value of this function, dp dt, is negative. And same story over here. And we have fixed points at the intersection. Where the growth rate is zero, the population is fixed. So it's very easy to get these two types of graphs mixed up. I think a few people were asking really good questions about this in the forum, so I thought it would be good to underscore this just one more time.